So now that we have our new project open, we have the project pegged to our assembly selected. Let's go ahead and make our file that we're going to work in. So we're going to go to New Document. We're not going to go to Part today. Today we're going to go to Standard Assembly. Don't go to Weldments. Go to Standard Assembly. And we should have an assembly file open. And you should have new tabs up here in your ribbon, like Assemble and Simplify. Well, we need to actually place all of our parts that we just copied from our J drive into this document. So we're not going to go to Place from Center. We're going to hit the drop-down arrow and make sure you have Place selected, not Place from Center. And then you should be able to find all your documents in here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to select them, and we're going to drop them in. We hit Open. And we place it in. And we can see this part is in here. And I can place multiple if I want to. I'm not going to. And if at any point you're confused on what's going on, remember, you can look at your document that you taped in your notebook already. And you can see what we are doing in the end, or what our final product will be. Or if you look in your project folder or in your J drive, if you didn't copy it, you can open up the picture of the completed final product. If you would like to see what the final product should look like. But if we look at this picture, we can see, well, we have four of these little tiny circle pegs. We have four of our corner pegs. And if you look, I see one, two, three of these little small foot pegs down here. These pegs on the bottom, I'm calling them feet pegs. But if I look at my bottom view in this picture, I can see there's one, two, three, four, five. And then I can see that there's one of each of these one, two, three, four pegs. These weirdly shaped pegs, or these variously shaped pegs inserted in the holes. What holes, you might ask? Well, in the holes of this base that we just placed in. So we need to place all of these things in. So, okay, well, the corner peg. Well, we just said we needed four of them. So I'm going to go ahead and drop in four pegs. One, two, three, four. I'm going to right click and hit OK. I'm going to go to place again. What about my foot pegs? Well, we just said if we looked at the picture, there were five. One, two, three, four, five. And again, if you're confused, look at your tape in or look at the picture. And you'll see where I'm getting this from. So what other parts do we need? Well, okay, we've got the corner peg, we've got the foot peg, we've got the peg toy base. We need the polygon peg. I remember there's only one of these. So I'll go ahead and drop it in. What else was there? We need the round peg. We need one of these. It's going to go in this little hole right here. After round peg is the side disc peg. Oh, well, these are the little tiny ones. And there were four of these. Right click, OK. And again, I'm looking at my picture to know there were four. One, two, three, four. Or I could look at my top or my side view and I can see them. What else do we got? Well, it looks like we got a square peg and a triangle peg. So we're going to place both of these in, one of each as well. And our end goal is to make this assembly look like this picture here, these directions here. And we're going to add the constraints that are described in this Campus A drawing. So if you look at each one or each type of part in this picture, each one is described how it should be constrained together. Now, in this last step, or the last step we need to do before we finish this video, is we need to ground this first piece. So I'm going to right click on the very first piece. I can click on it here or in here. And I'm going to ground it so it cannot move. And if I have grounded checked, then I'm good. And I want to make one final note that if during this video, if you went to place and you found yourself having to search through your files to place these parts in, they weren't already here in your project. It wasn't just right here like it was in mine. Then you didn't make your project folder correctly and you need to start over. Go back to video one. If not, move on to video three.